Here's Business Spotlight from your local voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990. And here's your host, George Bryant.
Good morning. It is, oh my goodness, Tuesday morning in the Mid-South. And we get to continue a great series we've been doing with Triumph Bank. Let's talk growth. They are about growth, but also behind all that is very personal business. They are a local community bank. And your host this morning has a great guest, Tracy Strickland. Welcome in our studios.
Good morning,
Tracy.
George. How are you this morning?
I'm doing great. I'm doing very grateful that we're not dealing with the horrible tragedy that they are over in Houston.
And pretty unthinkable. I have a cousin that is having water in her house right now, so I'm thinking about her every minute.
And I know
it's a nerve-wracking situation and really scary for that massive city to be going through such a tragedy.
Whew. We kind of know what some of those disturbances are like with, you know,
Hurricane Elvis and things that
tornadoes that we deal with a lot. But boy, this is just horrible. And,
we pray for everybody. Hardly even stop. You can't stop. So we're hoping that that slows down very quickly. But I'm very, very happy to welcome a guest. I know last week I introduced an event that we're hosting on October 3rd. It's the first event of a kind that we've ever held at Triumph. It's called Business Triumphs. And as we continually bring on our business lenders and we have such a business focus to our bank, we wanted to create an event for our business owners and all the listeners who may just need to get some advice on how to continue to grow their company. And then at that point when they're thinking about selling their business, what do they experience? And we're going to have some great experts. I'm really thrilled to have one of the gentlemen that's going to be serving as a panelist at our event. His name is Mike Bruns. He is the founder and the former president of Comtrak Logistics. I got to visit with him recently, and I told Mike I was the one who invited him into, had the idea to bring him on. He is a master entrepreneur in the Society of Entrepreneurs. One of the leading businessmen of this city, and hearing him speak at that event, I understand that not only he has a heart for business, but he has a heart for the people that work with him and a heart for serving the community. He's originally from Chicago, but he came down to Memphis several years ago. But I want to welcome Mike to our show and say, I know you you moved to Memphis several years ago, and we talked about the fact that when you started Comtrak, it could have easily been moved anywhere, but you decided to keep it in Memphis.
Well, that's correct. I moved here with the idea that I would stay for 2 years and fulfill the employer's needs, and then I would move back to Chicago. And when they filed for bankruptcy after a little bit, I was faced with the challenge of where to go, and I decided to stay here because it's a great city.
Right. Right. And what motivated you to start Comtrak? And, you know, I know it was kind of a funny start on how you even got in the logistics business and the trucking business to start with.
Well, yeah, I had some experience when I was in college. I went to work for a trucking company for 6 weeks to fulfill the pregnancy absence of somebody. And 6 years later, I guess I was a trucker 10-4 good buddy. I don't know. It wasn't exactly what the plan was, but and then my career moved me to Memphis, and that's kind of, I was just talking earlier that I don't know what I want to be when I grow up, but it's getting too late. But I certainly was in the logistics business and really, really had a wonderful career and a lot of people to be thankful for.
Absolutely.
We're talking with Mike Bruns.
Bruns.
Yep. Mike Bruns. What an exciting show we have, so don't go away. We got to take a quick break. You're listening to Let's Talk Growth on The Voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990.
KWAM, now on FM 107.9 and AM 990.
The Memphis Daily News Report, credible, reliable, always unbiased, the Daily News. Regions Bank and FedEx Corporation are financially backing a seminar this week at which 20 Regions bankers will offer customized business coaching for entrepreneurs. The Intercity Capital Connections Program takes place Tuesday from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. at the FedEx Institute of Technology. This is the second time the seminar has been held here. During that time, 27 participants in the program have gone on to create 139 jobs. First Tennessee's Bank's Franchise Finance Division now has a unit focused exclusively on restaurant financing. Reports state that the nation's top 100 restaurant chains accounted for nearly half of the total restaurant sales last year, and quick service eateries continue to steal market share from full service establishments. A $1.2 million building permit application has been filed for the former Sports Authority located in East Memphis. Sports Authority filed for bankruptcy in March 2016 and announced they would close all of their locations by that August. For these stories and more, make sure you pick up a copy of the Daily News Report. You'll find it everywhere around Memphis, and you can read the online edition at memphisdailynews.com.
Offers valid in U.S. 726 through 93017 on new vehicles. Rebates and financing vary by model year, subject to credit approval. See dealer for details. Always wear a helmet, never drink and drive.
The biggest off-road savings of the year can be yours right now during the Polaris factory authorized clearance. Rebates go as high as $4,000 and financing as low as 2.99% APR. Score a $1,000 rebate on Ranger XP 1000, the world's hardest working utility side-by-side. Or get the Sportsman ATV you've always wanted. Right now, select 450 and 570 models, save you $1,000. High performance Razor XP 1000 is a screaming deal with a $2,500 rebate. Or push the limits of performance and get $4,000 back on Razor XP Turbo. See Polaris.com or Polaris of Memphis now for rebates up to $4,000 and financing as low as 2.9% APR during the Polaris factory authorized clearance. Stop in Polaris of Memphis during their September through the 7th open house for more specials.
And now back to Business Spotlight on The Voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990.
Welcome back to our studios. Today we're picking up on Let's Talk Growth Triumph Bank with Tracy Strickland. As always, she has some fabulous guests. And today we're honored to have Mike Bruns, founder and former president of Comtrak. And what an interesting story that we're hearing. And so, Tracy.
Yeah, I'm thrilled to have Mike on. And we spent about an hour talking, and I think we could have talked all afternoon. And I've met a lot of CEOs over my years, and so many of them focus on the typical logistics of a business, the bottom line, the profit and loss, how are they going to make their business successful. And so it was a really wonderful and welcoming, eye-opening experience when I asked a question to Mike when we were visiting. I said, what's the one piece of advice that you could give to a business owner that might be coming to our event in October? Mm-hmm. And he'll be talking a lot more in depth at our event on October 3rd. But your immediate answer was all about culture. And I'd love for you to share what you built at Comtrak and why it was important to you, if you could.
Well, I appreciate the opportunity. First of all, George, thanks a lot. And Tracy, it's an honor to be here. Thank you very much. I would say that probably the most often overlooked characteristic of a company and its bottom line and how to achieve a larger bottom line is the culture. And we experienced at Comtrak, I think the key word to leadership, whether it was myself or anybody else that reported directly to me, was the word humility. And I think that leadership has to start with humility, and people want to respect the person that they worked for, and that respect is earned, not demanded. Mm-hmm. And I have seen so many leaders in the organizations that I've done business with that demand respect, and it's never earned. And I think the quickest way to earn respect is to roll up your sleeves and be a part of the team instead of necessarily leading the team from the throne, so to speak. I can remember that when I sold my company and a publicly traded company bought me, they said, Mike, you've got as much money as you need to run around the country and add to the fleet. We want to be the biggest truck line. And at the time, we were darn close in the country. Mm-hmm. And every quarter, I would report back, and they would say, who have you bought? And I said, nobody. And it was always the case because the cultures of the companies that I visited did not match our culture, their leaders. It wasn't going to fit. And so often, to your point, Tracy, everybody looks and due diligence, they look at all the columns and see if they all make sense, make sure they're black ink. But the fact of the matter is the culture was what drove the company to success. And we never did make an acquisition until after I left, and they started making acquisitions, and quite frankly, many of them were the wrong ones to make.
Well, and I love, you've always, you know, typically throughout your whole career, you've always put your money where your mouth is, I like to say. And your service into the community is amazing. And that has always reverberated into how you've run your culture and developed this sense of community with your, you've been chairman of the board for 12 years of Youth Villages. You're on the board of the Assisi Foundation, board of visitors of U of M, involved in the Baptist Healthcare Community Advisory Board, of course, past president of the Society of Entrepreneurs. So you're so busy, but I think that the work that you did in the community, you just brought that heart to Comtrak every day.
Well, it, you know, I made a serious mistake initially at Comtrak, and I don't mind admitting it. I would run off to my meetings, various things that were going on in the community and leadership roles that I had within the community, and I didn't tell anybody where I was going within the company. And it was when I finally learned that if I involved the company with what I was doing, we would be even more successful. So all of a sudden, Youth Villages is an example, since you mentioned them. We had employees that would sponsor various cottages, be in charge of the Christmas gifts, and do all the things. We put signs or stickers, great big posters on our trucks. And all of a sudden, the people at work at Comtrak became so engaged, not only within their work that they do every day, but what else they had to offer everyone else. And I think it's the employer's responsibility. I said this to Tracy yesterday. Mm-hmm. It's our responsibility as leaders within the companies to offer opportunities for their employees to become involved. I think every single person in this world wants to be involved and wants to help. And if you don't believe it, just turn on the news right now and watch Houston. Everybody wants to be involved and help. Mm-hmm. And the employer has a responsibility to offer those vehicles by which they can do it. And the returns are much greater than just the organization they're helping. The returns filter down to the bottom line because people love to go to work.
It's phenomenal.
It's phenomenal. Incredible. What a great story. We're talking with Mike Bruns. He's the founder and former president of Comtrak Logistics. And we're with Tracy Strickland, part of Let's Talk Growth, Triumph Bank. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. You're listening to The Voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990.
The voice for the Mid-South, FM 107.9 and AM 990.
Well, Jason, I've got to tell you, you're pretty much everything this company is looking for in an entry-level candidate.
Great.
Your resume isn't quite what we're used to, but you've got a fantastic work ethic.
Thank you.
And I'm impressed by how you carry yourself.
So, should we talk about the job?
What, the job? Oh, sorry. Yeah, I have no way of recruiting or even meeting you. This interview didn't happen.
It may sound ridiculous, and that's because it kind of is. There's a huge pool of talent your company is missing out on. Meet the grads of life. Who are they? Talent worth knowing about. Young adults of unique determination and experience. An ideal fit for your company in an entry-level position, internship, or even mentorship. They might not have every qualification you typically look for, but they're exactly who your company needs.
Man, we really confused him.
Don't miss out on a resource many innovative companies have already discovered. Go to gradsoflife.org to learn how to find, cultivate, and train this great pool of untapped talent. Brought to you by the Ad Council and gradsoflife.org.
If you're looking for a commercial van to take your business to the next level, ask for more. The Ram ProMaster and ProMaster City vans were designed to do more. With the Ram ProMaster City, you can hold more with best-in-class cargo capacity, handle more with best-in-class payload, organize more with custom upfits, and get more out of every mile with unsurpassed fuel efficiency. Visit ramtrucks.com to make your business run stronger with a Ram ProMaster or ProMaster City commercial van. Based on small commercial van segment, Ram is a registered trademark of FCIUS LLC.
How strong is Allegra D?
It's my congestion's out of my way strong. Even in the park, playing with my dogs. Go fetch, Bosley.
Allegra D, a fast, non-drowsy antihistamine, plus a powerful decongestant that starts relieving your toughest allergy symptoms in under 1 hour.
Allegra D is breathing free for 24 hours strong, even in the convertible.
Allegra D, strong relief for your allergy symptoms. Guaranteed or your money back. Visit Allegra.com. Use only as directed.
And now back to Business Spotlight on The Voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990.
Welcome back to our studios. Let's Talk Growth with Triumph Bank, a great program that we've been doing this series for, you know, seems like
a year and a half.
Yeah, a lot of great guests have come in like today, and so we're going to turn this back over to Tracy Strickland.
Thanks, George. Having Mike Bruns on, it just gives me kind of hope for the world, and I'm not trying to overspeak this morning. I really love to talk with people who have such a passion in their heart for service. Mm-hmm. And you made such a difference when you led your team at Comtrak. You built a culture that also was part of an incredibly successful business. It was 7 years ago, right, when you sold Comtrak. And so, you know, as we're preparing for our Business Triumphs event that's coming up on October 3rd, if you're interested in coming, please go to our website, triumphbank.com. You can register right there online and hear more from Mike and our other speakers and panelists. But one of the questions when we were visiting yesterday that I loved your answer to, because, again, it gave a different tilt to what a typical answer that I was expecting was, you know, when I asked Mike, you know, what were some of your obstacles that you faced 7 years ago that might have been stumbling blocks, possibly, and instead of saying, well, I didn't have the right advisors or whatever, you talked about the fact that you needed more time to prepare your entrance plan instead of your exit plan. Right. So I would love for you to share a little bit more about what you meant by that, if you could.
Well, obviously, before I would make such a serious decision as selling a business, I made sure that all of the parts about exit were, the T's were crossed and the I's were dotted as best I could. And one point I wanted to make along those lines was that for those people who are older and selling and probably having no access to get back into a business, they need to make sure that their employees are protected. That was a serious thing for me. I had seen other companies sold to very similar companies. A truck line buys a truck line. Well, you can say there's two vice presidents of everything and somebody's going to lose their job. Right. And so I was able to sell to a company that we had a lot of leverage. But having said that, the exit plan of the company was a lot easier than the entrance plan, or at least I had to concentrate more on what are we going to do? What am I going to do moving forward? And I see so many people that have successful businesses my age in the mid-60s, and they sell their company, and they collapse. Quite frankly, they're lousy at everything else they've ever done because that's all they've ever done, and they didn't have any practice. And I'm not talking about golfing every day because I don't think anything is a lot of fun if you get to do it every day. Mm. But I would tell you that I was lucky enough to know that all of the organizations that I had become a part of with Comtrak, I was able to stick with them and turn up the gas a little bit more and give them some more time and more financial resources and things like that. And I was also able to take on additional community endeavors. But I didn't even do that very well, even though I was worried about my entrance, because I took on more than I should have, quite frankly, in a lot of cases. But I do think for someone that continually worries about their exit, they need to spend almost as much time on what their entrance is going to be so they don't go from 100 miles an hour to zero, because it won't work if you do.
Right. Well, when you were talking about who you were going to sell the business to, one thing that was like, and your team was so important to you, and I know continues to be, even though you're not with them every day, but you mentioned, like, you could have easily sold to multiple different trucking companies, and he said, right, you know what, if I've got this, you know, pile of money in my pocket, and then you run into one of your former team members who lost their job because of that sale, then it's not worth anything, right?
There's so much truth to that. I've seen so many people, and we all know folks who think that, you know, by the way, money is an overrated commodity, so let's just get that out of the way. The fact of the matter is that if you do go into the restaurant that you've sold your company and you bump into your old employee that actually helped you build that company and helped you get that pile of money that's in your blue jeans, and you turn around and you have to look at him and he lost his job because you did sell the company, then you're not very rich. And I learned that lesson from someone else in this city that had to sell their truck line or did sell their truck line, and I wasn't going to make that mistake. So I can walk into any restaurant, any room, anywhere I want, and I don't drop my head because I sold the business.
That's right. That's right. Well, and you're a leader that leads by example, and I think that people respect that. They want to work where they feel like they can be part of something bigger than just working 8 to 5 or whatever the hours are every day.
That's right.
And that makes a big difference.
Great conversation.
Yeah.
Mike, thank you so much for coming in today.
Oh, it was my pleasure. I'm real proud to be here, and it was honored to partake.
It just gives us a little taste of this conference that you guys are doing.
That's
Tracy,
right.
Tell us real quick about how we can get involved in that.
Absolutely. So if you go to our website, it's triumphbank.com. Of course, you can find out all about our other services and different products that we have for our customers. But as soon as you get to the website, there is right at the front of the website is a link that you would click on. You register online. It is from 3:30 to 5:30 at the University of Memphis in their FedEx Center of Technology, mm-hmm. the Zone Room. It's amazing. It's on Innovation Drive. We're going to have a keynote speaker coming in from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, who is an exit strategy specialist. And then we're going to have our local panel of experts with Mike and others, John Babango, Chip Marston, Mitchell Spurlock, and Jeffrey Meskin coming in from New York City to come and talk and give different perspectives of the different things that business owners are going to be thinking about as they're approaching selling their business, and then others that are thinking about growing their business or buying other businesses. It's going to give them an awesome perspective and some great resources.
What a great thing for you to do for the community, the business community, and it's just going to be amazing. How much is it to get?
Well, that's the best part. It's free. So it's no cost. We really want to do this as a service to the community and to the business owners out there. Memphis, as we know, is one of the most entrepreneurial cities in the country.
Absolutely.
And we're proud of that fact. And we have a rich talent in our city. And we're just going to showcase a few people that have had some major successes. So we welcome anybody who wants to come. Registration is open starting last week. So please join us.
So you better get a seat.
Please do.
Get a seat.
First come, first serve.
Tracy, thank you again. Mike, thank you.
It's great
meeting you and having you here today. And we'll be back next Tuesday, same time. Same station. You're listening to The Voice, FM 107.9 and AM 990.